appreciate that. In your budget, where do we find places that school safety, security are addressed, and where do we find places that services for mental health, which I understand we had a problem with our contractor, that, you know, where do we find that? Has that been addressed?
So the operational budget does have money. We put things in there for school safety, and we also rely on the school safety grant. We can request $250,000 a year in funding from the school safety grant. Typically, we get between $150,000 and $200,000 in that grant. So we utilize that grant a lot, but we also have money built in operational budget and it's on for operations specifically. And then regarding mental health, we have funds set aside for mental health, but we just received a school community grant, and we're going to utilize some of that for some mental health supports at the high school. And then we're also applying for other grants to help offset some of the differences in cost. We have right now roughly about $150,000 for community mental health type aspects in the budget between the general operating budget and student services funds. We can apply it that direction. And then we're also looking for other ways. If the school, what I talked to the board about, what our board about, was if we get additional funds from the state, that we would apply those firsthand to making sure our mental health needs of our students are being met.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Wade, did you have anything?
She got to my question about the mental health, so thank you.
Harris?
No, sir.
Okay. Just a few questions. Could you go back to the budget and revenue breakdown, please?
Yep.
No,
that one?
That one. Yep.
Yes, sir.
CARES funds, $4.2 million.
Correct.
So what happens when that goes away?
Any positions being funded by that go away, but we didn't fund positions with CARES funding. We actually took some of that money and put it towards the construction project for the high school. So that money has to be spent by the end of 25, which will be...
So you're not funding positions?
We're not funding. We're doing nothing budgeted. We have some positions that are being funded through CARES funds, but they're not in our operational budget. So they know when we hire those people, they were a one-year or two-year.
Which leads me to my next question. So I believe the student-to-teacher ratio, which can be misleading, is 1 to 24, correct? And you vary, I think it's anywhere from 1 to 16 or whatever. You don't need to look.
Okay.
My question is this. Are you adequately staffed?
I feel right now.
Do you believe that class sizes are appropriate?
I think our class sizes, looking at everything this year, are appropriate. Obviously, the mental health capacity we're talking about, but... that is an issue we need to focus on, and so I think that's something we need to think about hard. But again, as far as the day-to-day classroom sizes right now, I feel we're adequately staffed.
I think you mentioned that depending on where the state ends up with their budget, you'd be short, was it like $820,000?
If they go off the skinny budget, we would be short $852,000.
And where would you find that without affecting instruction?
We would have to look at the pay increases and other things like that within our budget would be the first place we would look, and then we'd have to look at staffing, but I would want to go to staffing.
All right, last is a request and not a question. So I understand that the auditorium and other things are going out to bid in the next week or so.
Yes, sir.
Would you mind coming back to us at a future meeting and just let us know where we stand on all that?
I'll be glad to.
Thank you very much.
Just let me know a date and I'll be here.
I'm sorry, I had three questions. I've got to ask the third one. SROs in the school, does that come in your budget, or is that in the sheriff's budget, or do you all work together on that? And will you have enough?
Yes, it's combined between our budget, the sheriff's budget, and the school safety grants that we SRO grants we've applied for. So it's multiple areas it comes from. We have SROs now that split between some elementary schools. We have one at both middle schools. We have one at the high school, and we have one that works through AEC. So we're getting better. I would love to have one at every school. Right now, we're not funded at every school, but that's something I would love to see happen. But we do have them assigned to a north end elementary and south end elementary, so they're going between elementary schools depending on the time of day, and we vary that schedule so there's no, you can't get a pattern. But then also at our middle schools, our secondary schools have, they're staffed with SROs right now.
And what about our rural schools like Elon and Temperance, where are they in that mix?
So Temperance falls in the north, so with the three elementary schools on North End, Central, Temperance, and Amherst Elementary share an SRO. They're on the South End, Madison Heights, Amelon, and Eland share an SRO. But they also, the secondary SROs will respond to those schools if there's not one there.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone else? Thank you, Dr. Wells.
Thank you.
Very informative. All right, moving on.